Hi, this is Joshua Stern with the Stern team at Keller Williams, and my goal is to keep you educated about all things real estate so you have the ability to make great decisions when it comes to your own home selling, buying, and investing goals. So today's topic is disclose, disclose, disclose. Thanks again for watching the video blog. Before we get started, I wanted to point out two features on our site just to the right. First is a really great tool that you can use to get a free home value estimate instantly for your own home. And second is our buyer site. And this link will bring you to real-time listings of all homes from all brokerages covering the entire Wasatch Front. So now back to our topic. Don't be afraid of the seller's disclosure. State and federal laws are strict in requiring sellers to tell what they know about the condition of their homes that isn't obvious or discernible to a potential buyer. See, buyers can't see behind walls or under houses, so they rely on truthful information from the seller about the operations, appliances, and the systems of a home. So when you sell a home, your real estate agent's going to present you with a federal and or a state mandated disclosure called a real estate disclosure statement or a property condition disclosure. You're required to disclose the presence of things like lead paint, radon, asbestos, and other toxic products if you know your home has them. While the forms may ask you to disclose whether or not you know there is lead paint or radon present, you aren't required to do tests to determine the presence of toxic chemicals. But your buyer's lender can always require proof of tests and/or remediation for any problem that has been disclosed, such as fire or maybe even water damage. It's important to answer every question as truthfully as you can. You must answer the questions yourself. You see, your real estate agent, as a professional, cannot fill out the disclosure for you, but he or she can help you understand what's being asked of you. If you're in doubt about what to disclose, such as repair, it's best to err on the side of too much information than not enough. While disclosure forms allow you to check the I don't know box or write NA off to a question, you should only do so if you truly don't know the condition of that item. If you answer that you don't know the condition of an appliance that you use daily, such as a sink or bathtub, that might actually raise some suspicions in the eyes of a buyer. So the best way to feel confident about the condition of your home is to have it inspected by a licensed professional home inspector. You see, your real estate professional can recommend somebody or someone that can provide you with a list. A few $100 and a few hours of your time, you'll either find that your home is market ready or the inspector will bring a problem to your attention that you can fix. Thanks again for taking the time to watch this blog. If you have a question about a property, please feel free to give us a call or send us an email.